Well, hello, friends and family. I'm so glad y'all come back to be with us today. We are going to be in the kitchen today, and we're going to be doing some meal prep for the week. I usually do this on either Saturday or Sundays, and I'm going to be doing some extra things. I'm going to be making some chicken pot pie for my daughter. She's been wanting some chicken pot pie, so I thought I'd make her a single-serving chicken pot pies for her to keep in the freezer, and she can take it out. Her husband doesn't care for chicken pot pie, so, of course, he'd have to eat something else. But she loves them, and this will be something for her to come in from work. She works really hard every day, and to come in, it's just her and him. Like I said, there's no children, so this will be something she can pop in the oven and serve with a salad or something and be a good meal. But I love doing meal prep for the week, but I also love to be able to take very few ingredients and make lots of meals out of it and be able to share it with other people. And that's what we're going to be doing today. Going to be taking two chickens and putting them in the slow cooker, letting them cook all night. The next day, we'll be able to get all of our stuff, our meals together. I'll have my chicken, my broth, and I'm also going to be cooking up four cups of dry rice, which usually at least doubles once you get it cooked. You can use any kind of rice you want to, but what I do is I will put two cups in a freezer bag, and I freeze them like that. And anytime I need rice during the week, I just take out a bag, put it in the refrigerator the night before, and when I come in from work, I've got rice for whatever, stir fry or whatever I need it for. So that's part of my meal prep. But anyways, y'all stay with me, and we're going to do some meal prep, and we're also going to make some frozen meals to put in the freezer. And for y'all that there's just two of y'all, or even just one, you can do this. And this, what I'm going to do is make them in smaller portions, so there'll be at least enough for two servings or for one person, and have leftovers for the next day. Or you'll be able to do a bigger batch for a bigger family, whichever. But this recipe is going to work for either size family or how many servings you want to get out of it. So anyways, I'm excited to get this done so I don't have to worry about it anymore this week, and I'll have at least that much done. And I can share it with my family and my friends. And so y'all stick around, and let's see what we can do with two chickens and four cups of rice. Welcome to Whippoorwill Holler. I'm Miss Lori, and this is Mr. Brown. We live in the hills of Arkansas. We love the Lord. Keepers of the old way, but accept some of the new. We love to cook, and we love to eat. We love to garden. It's in our blood. It's how we stay sustainable and fill our pantry. We do a lot of canning and preserving. We live a sustainable life. We love our family. We work hard. And every once in a while, we like to dance. So y'all join us. Okay, I want to show y'all that I cooked four cups of rice, and I got it all spread out here and letting it cool, because we're going to be doing several different things with all this rice that I've got cooked ahead. Some of it I'll be using in a casserole, and some of it I'm going to be putting up for other different suppers or breakfast, anything like that. So I always, on Sundays, usually try to make me some rice and put it up. Okay, the first thing I did is I put two whole chickens in my slow cooker, and I cooked them overnight, and I cooked enough meat to make a lot of different meals and cooked me up some good broth. Okay, so I deboned my chicken, and I strained my broth. So we got quite a bit of meat here to work with. And I'm thinking I can get several meals done with this. So we just need a few more ingredients. and we're going to get our chicken pot pie made. Okay, so this is our ingredients for our pot pie. Our chicken, our broth. I've got 2 small bags of peas and carrots, and I've got one of my quart size home canned potatoes, and I am going to cheat, and I'm using some frozen pie crust that I had in the freezer, and I just thawed them out in the refrigerator last night. I always keep frozen pie crust just for stuff just like this. Okay, let's get the base of our chicken pot pie started. I've got about a 6-quart pan pot here, and I'm going to put a 1/2 cup, 1 stick of salted butter. You can use unsalted butter, whichever you prefer. Okay, we've let our butter start to melt. And I'm going to add 1/2 cup of flour. And I'm just going to stir this good. Stir the lumps out. And I'm going to keep stirring this and let it cook for a couple of minutes to cook that raw flour. And then I'm going to be using my broth from my slow cooker. Okay, so I'm just starting to add my broth that I made by slow cooking those 2 chickens to make my base. I'm not going to be using milk. It's a really rich broth. And I'm not really going to have to season this broth much. I'm going to add just a little bit more. Because when I put my chicken in there, I added salt and pepper, and I added some thyme and some poultry seasoning. But I will be tasting as I go to see if it needs a little bit more salt and pepper. And as it's cooking, it's thickening up. And then I'll just add a little bit more broth to it. I don't just add the whole thing of broth. And I've probably got about 2 quarts of broth that I ended up with. But I don't want to use it all at once because I'll be adding my vegetables and all that to it, my potatoes. And I'm not sure how much liquid I'm going to need. So I just do it a little bit at a time. And I'll let it thicken up in between each time before I add more broth to it. That way I can control the base, that it won't be too thick or it won't be too thin. So there's really not, you know, just a so-so recipe for this. It's just as you go and you eyeball it and you taste it and you make it your own. I do a lot of recipes that way. But when you're making a base like this to a chicken pot pie, you don't want it real, real thick unless you just want a pot pie that's the, once you get it cooked and baked, you know, you got the crust and you got your filling, and the filling's just so thick, there's not much juice in there. I like a little bit of juice. When I cut into that pie and that crust, I like just a little bit of juice to kind of come out with it. So that's all up to you and how you like your chicken pot pie or your turkey pot pie or your beef pot pie, whichever. And you're going to be adding probably different vegetables to it that's even going to make it even thicker. You know, you're going to be having mushrooms or green beans or corn or stuff like that. So you just eyeball it, make it the thickness you want and how you like it. So it's still getting thick, and I'll probably add the rest of my broth to it here in a little bit. Now make sure that you taste your broth too. Make sure it tastes the way you want it to taste. Now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to add my frozen vegetables. I wanted to get these out because they're going to start going the other way and start getting freezer burnt. So we needed to drag these out and going to make a delicious pot pie with them. I want to show you the brand that I absolutely love in frozen vegetables. And this is Cascadian Farm. It's organic, and these are peas and carrots, but they have all kinds of different vegetables and frozen fruits. And I get these from Thrive Market. Now, you can get them. I think you can get this brand at Kroger. I'm not sure, but it is one of my favorites. And, of course, being organic, it's going to be a little bit higher,
But they are really, really good frozen vegetables. I went ahead and added my quart of my home canned potatoes. And some of the potatoes were kind of in big hunks, so I kind of cut them up a little bit. But this is one way of using your canned potatoes, and it turns out really good. They taste really good in a cream base in a pot pie like this. Okay, we got everything in our pot, except I'm not going to add any chicken to this. What I'm going to be doing something a little bit different with my chicken. I did taste it, and after adding my potatoes and my peas and carrots, I taste it, and it does need just a little bit more salt and pepper. It doesn't need any more thyme or anything like that. That's just fine. But at this point, you need to taste it and make sure, it tastes like you want it to. But it's all coming together, and it's going to be delicious. And it's going to be so good to have something like this frozen in the freezer and ready to go. Okay, these disposable pans that I'm going to be using are, I think, about a 5 by 8. So if you're not wanting to make the smaller portion of pot pie, which will feed two people, or to feed one and then leftovers for the next day. And I'm not going to make this just perfect. I'm just going to cut it in half to fit the pan, and I'm just going to fit it in there the best I can. I don't have time just to make it beautiful on the bottom. All we're wanting is just, crust on the bottom. That's all we're wanting. And I did spray my pans. So I'm going to go ahead and do all of my four pans. And if you're wanting to do this in bigger portion, do it in a 9 by 13. This will make 2 9 by 13s, I'm pretty sure. This will be plenty of filling for it, and plenty of crust. It's because I had four frozen crust. So I done four of the 5 by 8 disposable pans. And now I'm going to start putting my filling in here. And this should be plenty of filling for four of these, or 2 9 by 9 by 11 or 9 by 13, or even the bigger, I forget the size now, but the bigger baking dish that's bigger than 9 by 13, I can't remember. Anyways, because I don't have any that big. I think a 9 by 13 is the biggest baking besides my my big Dutch ovens and stuff. I don't think I've got anything any bigger than that. But what I'm going to do is I'm taking my chicken, instead of mixing it up in the filling, I'm just going to layer it on top of my filling. That way I can control how much chicken I'm using in my pot pies, and make sure I get enough chicken in there. And this is a way that I do when I make chicken and dressing and stuff like that. So we'll get this chicken on there, and then we'll put the top crust on, and we'll be done. And we'll have all this done pretty quick. And it's going to be delicious. Okay, we're going to do the same thing with the top crust, but I'm going to roll it out just a little bit. It don't have to be perfect, just like the bottom crust wasn't perfect. I'm just going to roll it out to fit my pans. And I ain't going to cut it out exactly 5 by 8 in an exact rectangle. But either way, it's going to work. And it's going to be a good crust. Just crimp your edges over. It don't matter. Maybe one end's longer than the other. It don't have to be pretty. Just has to taste good. And these are the great value from Walmart, pie crust. And I keep them in the freezer all the time. These are really good pie crust for the, I think they're like $1.86 a box at my Walmart. So that's not bad for two. And I was going to go ahead and put some slits on the top, but I'm not going to because I don't want none of that juice to come out, and we'll do that before we bake them. Now, these pans did come from the Dollar Tree. They're not the sturdiest, but they will work. And they come with these lids. I'm just going to push that down in there. And I'm going to cover this with my lid before I wrap it. I'm not going to wrap it with foil. I'm going to just wrap it with a good plastic wrap. And you just kind of crimp over the sides. So you get two of these. Used to be two for a dollar, but now it's two for a dollar and a quarter, of course. But still, that's not bad. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write on the top what's in here, which is chicken pot pie. And then I'll write the date on it. And then I'm just going to write the instructions on it. Because, like I said, I'm going to be giving a couple to my daughter. And I don't want her forgetting and leaving the lid on it or anything like that. But so I put that you cook it at 350 at the frozen. You want it to still be frozen. You don't want thawed out. Anywhere from 45 to 50 minutes for this size. But you just have to keep checking it. All ovens are different. And I want her to know that when you take it out, you need to cut little slits on top of the top crust. And just cook it and enjoy it. So this is what I'll be doing to all of my pot pies. And like I said, these aren't the sturdiest pans, but once you wrap it in either foil or a couple layers of plastic wrap, it does help it. And plus the fact when you freeze it, when it's frozen solid, it's better too. It's not as flimsy. But sometimes you just have to do that to save money. And so a better, heavier duty disposal pan would have cost more. So there we go. And that's how I will wrap them all up, just like that. Instructions on the front and ready to go. Let's see how much chicken we have left. We've got enough chicken for a couple more meals. In fact, I'm going to take half of this chicken and I'm going to put it in a freezer bag. And I'm going to put this in the freezer because there's so many things that I can do for me and Danny with this much chicken. Just so many different recipes. It could be soup. It could be a little pan of chicken and dressing. Just so many things. Chicken and dumplings. So I'm going to use the rest of this chicken and we're going to make some Mexican chicken casseroles to put in the freezer. I'm going to say we've got about 4 cups of chicken. And over here we've got about 4 cups of our rice. I'm just kind of breaking some of this chicken up. Some of it's still in pretty big hunks. But I've got about four cups of rice over here. Y'all remember at the beginning I had cooked 4 cups of dry rice, which made about 8 cups or more. I think it made more than 8 cups, especially by my measuring cups. But anyways, we're going to put 4 cups of chicken, 4 cups of rice in here. And I'm going to put these in the same size disposable pans to freeze. But you can do the same with this recipe. You can put it in 2 9x13s because it will work. So it's kind of amazing how many meals we're going to be getting out of 2 chickens that we cooked overnight in the slow cooker. Now I'm just going to mix this chicken and rice up real good before I put the rest of my ingredients in it. Now this is a casserole that you can make how you like it, but I'm going to be showing you the ingredients that I'm going to be putting in here. Now we're putting in 2 cans of cream of chicken soup. You can put a can of cream of chicken, a can of cream of mushroom. If you've got your own homemade, that's good. This is some green chilies. You can use a can of Rotel. I don't care for Rotel myself. I'd rather use green chilies. This is a small can of Mexican corn. I love this corn. It's so good. It's always so sweet.
and it's got a good taste to it. It's got little red bell peppers in it. You can put you some black beans in here. That would be good. And like I said, you can use a can of Rotel, but this is what I do. I like using a can of green chilies, and then I like to put a whole can of diced tomatoes in there. I just rather do that. I just don't really care for the way they can up their Rotel. So, either way, it tastes good. Now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to add my can of diced petite tomatoes. You can add black olives. Like I said, black beans, pinto beans, anything like that. Now we are going to be adding some seasoning to this. And like I said, this is going to make four of my 5x8 little pans, or you can put it in two 9x13s and it will work that way. I'm going to put about a teaspoon of garlic powder. I'm going to put some onion powder. Probably about a teaspoon of onion powder. I'm going to grab some cumin. I love my cumin. And if you don't like cumin, don't put it in there. I'm going to put a good teaspoon of that. And then I'm going to get me some chili powder. That's not chili powder. That was ground cloves. We don't need no ground cloves in there. So where's my chili powder? And we're going to put about a teaspoon of chili powder too. I'm not going to put any salt and pepper because of my cream of chicken soup is going to be plenty salty enough, I know. So we're just going to stir all this up good. I've sprayed my pans. And this is just another good meal, good frozen, or you can go ahead and cook it now. And just another good one to put in the freezer that come together really easy. I'm putting 2 cups of cheese in here. And mix that up good. Now, I will wait, and I'll tell my daughters the same thing. I'm not going to put cheese on top of this and then put a lid on it, because that cheese will just stick to the lid. So what I do is I'll go ahead and right, probably about 5 minutes before you take it out of the oven, before it's done, I'll put more cheese on top. Okay, so it was enough for 3 5x8 pans. And it will be plenty enough for a full 9x13 or whatever. Now, I know this looks like caviar, but this is chopped up black olives I'm putting on top. And the reason I'm using these is I bought the wrong kind. I thought they were sliced, but they're chopped up. And I love the taste of olives on top of Mexican casseroles. So I'm not going to let these go to waste. I'm going to go ahead and use them. It really ain't pretty, though. But you ain't going to see it once you put cheese on top of it anyways, before you get it out of the oven. But I've been wanting to use these. It was my fault. I bought the wrong kind. So it does. It looks like caviar on top of my casserole there. But anyways, our casserole's done. And we're going to put the lid on it. And get them wrapped up. Get the instructions on them. Like I said, this will be one that you'll take out of the freezer the night before and thaw it out in your refrigerator. And the next day, you'll just put it in your oven at 350 and just probably cook it for about 30 minutes just till it's heated through and through. And 5 minutes before you take it out, put you a little bit more cheese on top, and it's going to be delicious. Just make sure you don't buy chopped up olives like I did, because they're not very pretty, but they taste good. If you like black olives, and I do. This recipe is really good with sour cream. Yum, yum.
Okay, let's try to simplify all this and see what we got. So we started out with two chickens that I had put in the slow cooker overnight, let them cook all night. I also made broth in there with them. So I got my chicken and my broth cooked. So we got four small of our chicken pot pies for me and Danny and a couple of the kids if they want them. We used, 12-ounce bag? I'm going to say it was around maybe 24 ounces of frozen carrots and peas. I'll have to look. I don't remember now. I should have looked. And then I used 1 quart of my home canned potatoes. It was just 1 quart. 1 quart was plenty. Some of the pieces were kind of big, and I cut them up and put them in there. Y'all see how it done, and it done real good. So we got that 4 meals right there with that. Plus, we got 3 meals out of the 2 chickens. And 1 can of Mexican corn, 2 cans of cream of chicken soup, 1 can of green chilies, spices, and cheese, a couple cups of cheese. So we got 3 meals here. Or if you're feeding a bigger family, and you probably got 1 here for a big family, or 1.5, something like that. Okay, with them 2 chickens, I've got enough chicken here that I'm going to put in the freezer that I can either thaw this out and make a small pan of chicken and dressing. I can make, next week, I can make some kind of chicken dumpling. I can make a soup, anything. There's just so many recipes I can do with this chicken. Okay, we had our rice. I cooked 4 cups of dry rice. And usually when you cook, I usually come out double when I cook my rice, and I the way I do it. So I ended up putting 4 cups of my cooked rice with all of my ingredients here for the Mexican chicken casserole. And then I've got 2/4-6 cups right here. I've got 2 cups in each one of these bags. And one of these bags will probably be used for a stir fry. One may be used for breakfast for sweet rice. Mr. Brown loves sweet rice. And then I love just taking rice with butter and salt and pepper, maybe a little gravy on it. But you just never know what you might need. You might want to stuff some bell peppers or something. So all this with 4 cups of cooked rice, my 2 chickens, and then stuff that I had in my pantry and in my freezer. And even over here, don't look at my dirty dishes, but I've still got enough of this that I can put this in a freezer bag. I can put it in the freezer, and sometime we need a quick meal, I can heat this up and serve it over biscuits. So we got several meals out of 2 chickens. 4 cups of dry rice, and whatever pantry items I could find.
So, I hope y'all enjoyed today's video and just showing y'all what y'all can do with things out of your freezer, out of your pantry, stuff you already have. You can put together this many meals. You can make it, put it in your own freezer, make it for your family, make it for your neighbors, some elderly people that maybe need some freezer meals. Like my daughter, Allison, my youngest daughter, she puts in a lot of hours. It's just her and her husband. She loves chicken pot pie. So this is really, she's really going to enjoy this. So if you like this video today, give us a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. It really helps us. And I can tell y'all have just been so good to us, and we love you all. I want to show y'all something real quick. Y'all see back here behind me, And any time that y'all seen my kitchen for years, y'all have seen this cabinet back here. And I want to show y'all something. I've been meaning to show y'all this, and I either forget about it until I see it sitting there again, and it sits in my kitchen window, and I absolutely love it. Is that not the sweetest thing you ever seen? One of my sweet subscribers made this herself. She makes, she's carrying on her dad's tradition of making dollhouses and furniture for it. And she sent me some beautiful pictures of the stuff that he done and stuff that she's done. And it will just floor you how these dollhouses look like real houses. But if you'll see, it's got the little door just like mine back there. It's got the shelf in it. It's got the little drawers just like mine right here. And I'm going to show you something if I can get it pulled out. Even inside the drawer, it's got the little paper in there that matches it. And there's two tiny cookbooks. I hope my thing's focusing in, y'all. But there's two tiny cookbooks of the cookbooks, two of my older cookbooks that I've got that she made and put inside these drawers. I'm going to show y'all. And then, when you open it up, it looks just like the inside of my cabinet. Look at the scallops down here. That's exactly the way my old cabinet is down here. The reason I've got this old cabinet is my grandma had one on her back porch exactly like this one. And when I seen this, I had to have it, and Mr. Brown got it for me. But I'm just going to bring y'all down. Do y'all see? I mean, when I got this in the mail, I opened it up and I was just shocked and amazed. But this is my cabinet. And if I ever, ever get a dollhouse, this is going in it. I've always wanted one of them really pretty Victorian looking old handmade dollhouses. But this is just the neatest thing. Like I said, it sits up in my window. But I wanted to show y'all this. But we'll end this video, and I thank y'all very much, and I hope this helped y'all a little bit to at least give you some ideas and to show you how you can stretch things and make a lot of meals out of it. Freeze it for later. Like I said, share it, whatever it takes. We love y'all. God bless, and we'll see y'all in a couple of days.